Hello, I'm Katrine Baker for your adjustable base tutorial. We hope you've been sleeping well and have enjoyed using your adjustable base. We've created this short video with easy to follow step-by-step instructions so you can set up and maintain your adjustable base. So please, give us a couple minutes of your time.
This video will show you how to replace the actuator on your adjustable base. This is an actuator. It's the device that lifts or lowers a section of the adjustable base. It has the electric motor on one end and the actuator shaft, which moves in and out at the other end. If you need to replace it, follow these simple steps. First, unplug your adjustable base from all electrical connections and then remove the mattress from on top of the adjustable base. Next, turn your base over on its side or its back if that's safer for safety reasons. This should be performed by two people. Be careful not to put sideways pressure on the legs of the base to prevent them from bending or breaking. Now, find your actuator that needs to be replaced. On most bases, there are two actuators, one for the head deck and one for the foot section. In some models, there is a third actuator used for the lumbar support feature. Before you remove the actuator, you will need to first disconnect the electrical connections that lead from the actuator to the control box. The control box is located in the middle of the adjustable base and has these colored wire covers attached to it. Each actuator is color-coded on the control box, so you'll know where it is supposed to plug in. So go ahead and pull the wire that feeds the actuator you want to replace. Now you can safely remove the old actuator. To do this, remove the cotter pin on the end with a motor by gripping the pin with a pair of pliers and pulling it free from the cotter pin shaft. Before you remove the cotter pin shaft from its housing, be sure to hold the base of the actuator because the actuator will be free and drop loosely when disconnected. And one more note of safety here. If you try to replace the actuator while it is still on its feet and not resting on its side, when one end of the actuator is freed from the base, the deck section will drop down quickly, so make sure the platform is supported. That's why it's best to do this with the base on its side. Now you can remove the bolt on the shaft end of the actuator. It is attached to the lift arm, which raises or lowers a section or a platform of the base. To remove this bolt, you will need an Allen wrench to fit in the head of the bolt and a regular wrench to hold the nut on the other end. Once the old actuator has been removed, place it in the box your new actuator came in so you can either return or dispose of it. To install the new actuator, you will simply reverse the process you used to remove it. Align the new actuator with a lift arm, insert the bolt through the housing, then the lift arm, and through the other housing. Use the Allen wrench and the regular wrench to tighten the bolt. On the motor end of the actuator, insert the cotter pin shaft and then secure it with a pin. Now you can plug the new actuator's electrical connector back into the control box and plug the base into the wall and then test the unit to make sure the new actuator is working. Finally, secure the wires that lead from the control box to the new actuator. And then, return the bed back to its normal position and place the mattress back on the adjustable base.
We're here to make sure you're completely satisfied with your adjustable base. So thank you for your time. Good night.